Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. My name is Pierre Mpele, otherwise known as Pam Boy, and this is your new favorite fashion program. I'm here today with Aurore Gibrien and Karim Belgiran, a makeup artist and a hairstylist working in the fashion industry. And this moment is for you to learn a little bit more about what they do and what passionate them. When did you realize that you wanted to work in the beauty industry?
Well, I think when I was 6 years old, it was the 90s. I come from a Moroccan family. So two of my sisters, like big hair, we went to the store, we bought some the straightener. And I spent like all evenings like doing my mother's and my sister's hair for hours. And then I realized, I don't know, I wanted to be a hairstylist. I didn't know I could work in fashion, but I think that was the moment that I put my step on hairstyling.
That's a beautiful story. I love when there's a family, you know, history behind what we love to do.
A lot of hair in my family.
What about you, Aurore? Tell me.
Moi, en fait, à base, c'était pas ma vocation première. Je viens de la Guadeloupe et c'est lors du carnaval que j'ai vu, en fait, que j'ai eu cette envie de maquiller, de montrer différentes façons de maquiller, les différentes visions selon justement l'ethnie, le pays, la culture. Ça a été comme une révélation, en fait, tout simplement.
That's great. I love different stories, but here we are all together in the same room. What was your first job in fashion?
Well, I didn't start in fashion. I started in cinema. I was like 20 years old and that was for the movie The Perfume. And it gave me a lot of train with wigs and because it was a film in epic film, so it gave me a lot of tricks that I use right now in fashion.
You know, there's obviously, I think, an overlapping, you know, sense of creativity between movies and fashion. Tell me about your first job in fashion.
Mon premier travail, c'était dans le prêt-à-porter, je ne dirais pas la marque. Et en fait, on peut remarquer en fait qu'il y a une similitude entre le prêt-à-porter et le make-up, parce que prêt-à-porter consiste à habiller quelqu'un. Le make-up consiste aussi à habiller une peau. Donc, du coup, c'était une continuité. Donc, j'en ai appris. J'ai appris beaucoup de choses du prêt-à-porter. Je me rends compte à quel point c'est lié, en fait, dans le monde de la mode, les deux.
Well, obviously, you know, fashion is a big industry and there's so many different parts of it. And it's great to hear from, you know, makeup and hair because we don't often hear about what you guys do. In the past 12 months, we've been, you know, in the middle of a pandemic. It's been very difficult. What have you guys learned about yourself, creatively speaking?
I don't know if it's more creative or not, but I'm more patient than I used to be. The thing that has changed a lot before we will be all the time like running away, like running all the time, like on a plane, and I will stay home, like maybe we'll stay like 2 days or 3 days a month. And we start working more like local teams and not fly people from New York and from Asia and from Mexico to reunite everyone to do the same shooting. So it's good because I had the chance to work with people that I was all the time in contact with, but we didn't have that many chances to work together. And I think that's the thing that has changed my work now, that I have the chance to work with more the people that I love in my city.
That's important. Yeah. What about you, Aurore?
En fait, je partage le même avis que lui. J'ai appris beaucoup, on a beaucoup appris sur la fragilité de la vie, des imprévus, mais aussi on a appris que grâce à ça, en fait, on s'est rendu compte que la mode aussi, l'importance des relations dans la mode pour permettre d'évoluer et aussi la créativité, ça, en fait, ça a été comme un refuge en fait, pour surmonter ça et en même temps nous permettre d'être encore plus passionnés dans notre travail. Hormis le fait que ça soit négatif, ça a créé quand même des choses positives à travers cette pandémie.
And there was a very important topic in the past 12 months, even more than usual in the industry, is diversity and inclusion. We're three persons of color, actually, today speaking. So tell me about, you know, what does the fashion industry need to do to be more inclusive and more diverse?
En fait, la mode, actuellement, je peux dire qu'elle est beaucoup plus ouverte parce que, justement, il y a eu le mouvement Black Lives Matter, etc. Et on s'est rendu compte que, en fait, il n'y avait pas assez, justement, de minorités. Pour moi, la mode, maintenant, doit changer dans le sens où elle doit permettre au mérite, en fait, pas au mérite, vraiment au mérite du talent, tout simplement, pas aux connexions, pas C'est vraiment ça l'essence, en fait. Par la passion, choisir quelqu'un parce qu'il est talentueux, parce qu'il est passionné, tout simplement.
I agree with you. I think meritocracy is something that we need to absolutely channel and support. That's for sure. You guys, you know, you work part of what people usually define as the glam squad. So how would you define beauty? What is beauty for you guys? Aura, I'll go with you first.
Wow. Pour moi, la beauté, en fait, je pense que Karim partage ça avec moi. La beauté, c'est pas que le visuel, c'est pas que la plastique. Pour moi, la beauté, déjà, c'est la beauté de l'âme. Je sais que c'est un peu bateau de le dire, mais pour moi, en fait, c'est vraiment ce que la personne va dégager qui va faire, en fait, que c'est quelqu'un de beau. Pour moi, c'est ça la définition de la beauté.
Tu acquiesces,
bien sûr.
Do you agree? What's your definition of beauty?
No, we were talking about that. It's an attitude. It's a way of presenting yourself to the rest and to express yourself. Also, it doesn't matter if you're like, I don't know. We can make the example of Rosy de Palma. Who will say that Rosy de Palma, with 6 years old in the school with that nose, will be now a muse for all the photographers and designers? There she is. After like I don't know how many years, she's still being a muse for a lot of people. It's just the way you present that nose.
What's the most challenging thing about working in your part of the industry? Tell me all.
Je pense que le challenge, le plus gros challenge, la chose en fait dans la mode. En général, que ce soit un point make-up artist ou un hairstylist, c'est de le renouveau. Oui. Tout le temps se renouveler, tout le temps se remettre en question. Continuer de le faire avec passion, mais le renouvellement, l'ouverture par rapport au travail des autres, la curiosité, c'est la base, en fait, tout simplement.
Voilà. Yeah, you're right. Because hair and make-up, we always there. I don't know, but we have certainly you have a style. I have a style, but you have to be always on. And what is going on with the world and with fashion and with beauty, that's very challenging. And also carrying all those luggages all day.
Yeah.
I hate it.
Suitcases full of makeup and products.
We can open a salon everywhere, wherever we are.
What's the craziest or funniest story you can tell us about the work you do?
Je sais pas si c'est si marrant que ça. Sur le coup, c'était pas marrant, mais ça peut être marrant pour les autres. C'est de maquiller. J'étais sur un shooting et j'ai dû maquiller dans le noir avec la lumière de mon téléphone. C'est compliqué. Comment dire que c'est très compliqué? Mais du coup, je ne dirais pas si c'était sur quel shooting, pourquoi, pour quelles raisons. Voilà.
But that's a good one, to have to do makeup in the dark. I think that's a real skill, so...
Yeah.
She's good. What about you?
I had to cut someone's hair while she was sleeping on a bed. Yeah, that was crazy. Yeah, I arrived. It was Fashion Week. It was men's Fashion Week. And always, like, people is running out of time. And she came from LA, and then I go to the hotel, and I was booked to do the hair for the celebrity, and the agent opened the door, was like, obviously, come. And then I go in, like, she's sleeping, and this is a huge light. I was like, okay, but you can cut her hair like this. I was like, yeah, but how come? It's like, she's sleeping, don't worry. So the makeup artist was doing the makeup. I was cutting the hair like this while she was sleeping, and then she wake up, she was fully makeup.
Wow, okay.
This can only happen in fashion.
Yeah,
this
in Paris.
Can only happen
That's
in
so fashion.
Fashion.
But we did it.
Can you guys tell me a good advice that you would tell a younger person who is watching this and wants to be in this industry, wants to be a makeup artist or a hairstylist? What advice would you give them?
Alors, comment dire? Mon parcours, il est assez spécial dans le sens où moi, je me souviens quand j'étais en Guadeloupe. J'avais en fait une vision assez négative à peu près de la mode par rapport aux histoires et compagnie. Et je me disais, j'ai envie de faire du make-up mon métier, mais je sais que je dois rentrer dans la mode. Comment je vais faire? Donc en fait, moi, si je donne un conseil à donner aux jeunes, ne vous mettez pas de préjugés. Il faut juste être passionné, travailler, être curieux et surtout avoir confiance en soi.
Ouais.
Ça, c'est la base. Avoir confiance en soi, quel que soit, même si l'entourage vous dit vous n'allez pas y arriver, si vous avez confiance en vous, vous allez surmonter toutes les épreuves.
Ouais. That's a really good set of advice. That's What true. Advice would you give?
But same, and open your eyes and try to do try to do many different things. Also, if you're interested in makeup or in hair, try to assist a stylist or a photographer
so
you can have a different vision of everything. It's going to help you to understand more how the fashion works, and maybe it can give you also the energy to do it.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I can do that. I can do that too. I can do so. I understand the whole thing. It's just about understanding other people's jobs because we work in a team.
That's true. There's a, you know, there's a, everyone is dependent on everyone else, so we need to support each other.
Yeah.
Last question: what's the last song you've listened to today?
Song?
Yes.
Last song. I like Nigerian music. Wizkid, with I don't know. It was Wizkid.
Wizkid.
Yeah, I have.
Afrobeat is hot.
Yeah. I need that. It's my energy.
What about you? What's the last song you
I'm obsessed with this album of Royce Murphy, The Incapable. It was Incapable of Love. I don't know why, but I'm listening it since 1 week. On repeat. I can listen to
it. That's the only way to do it.
Yeah.
Thank you guys so much for stopping by. I was really, really grateful to have you on and to have your voices. And we will be back.
You know we should have got it together.